You the fruit guy?
Excuse me?
Was it you that brought the basket of oranges?
Nah, it was here when I arrived.
Fine. So who are you?
Today, I'm your driver.
And where are we driving?
To work.
That's it?
Yeah, we have to make an important stop along the way.
Where?
The ranch.
What ranch?
Just the ranch.
Fine. The morning seemed surreal, and I took in the magic. Why wreck it with meaningless chatter? As my tight-lipped chauffeur drove an hour through God knows where, I started to feel like I was in the middle of a bad dream, probably lying bloody and concussed in the alley behind the old Colony Club, my nose buried in a rotten orange peel. But no, this was no dream. The silence was real. The sound of the engine was real. The dust was real enough, too. And there was the ranch over the horizon. It all seemed familiar. The Sand family's overbearing mansion has been the talk of the headlines for decades, but few have managed to get closer than a few miles. I guess I'm just lucky. I didn't know you took private meetings, Mr. Sand.
Only if I expect good company.
I'm surprised my company ranks at all.
Today, yes. Today is a special day.
So it seems.
Do you often go to the old Colony Club, Jack?
Every week.
Meet any interesting people there?
As a rule, no.
Sometimes you make a date, right? Sometimes make new friends.
Sometimes, I guess. But that's not why I go.
And why?
I consider it a hobby.
A hobby. Do you know anything about my hobbies?
Well, judging by the half-dozen animal skins I stepped on walking over here, it's not much of a reach to say you like hunting.
Love it. Well, I say that now. It seemed so tedious when I was a child. Took ever so long. But now I'm older. I've developed a new talent.
What talent is that?
Patience. The will to wait for the right moment. Let's say you want a deer. You know, you deserve it. You've even decided what dishes its meat will go to and where you'll mount its horns. But to get that deer, you've got to wait. To sit in the bushes and stay nice and quiet. Professional hunters will tell you that the hunt is a rare craft. There are many rules. It's shrouded in mystery and ancient skill. Well, that's all complete nonsense. To get a deer, you just sit on the sidelines for a long enough time, pinpoint the moment when it's finally time to shoot. I learned the talent, Jack, but not like you. Oh, Jack, you truly are the master.
I don't understand.
Oh, come on, Jack. I know about the half million. I know your plan. Kendrick told me everything. Needless to say, I'm impressed. While some people learn to hold their breath for minutes on end and not to rustle the leaves too loudly, why, you decided to just become the foliage. You turned yourself into a bush, surrounded by deer who've been so fruitfully multiplying for decades. But all this time you've held your rifle at the ready. Forgive an old man his imagery, Jack. I've the heart of a poet, I confess.
Look, I don't know what was said between you and Kendrick. But it sounds like you got it wrong.
Oh, I think I understand everything just fine. And I think we understand each other quite well. Jack, in the coming war, we'll make excellent partners.
What war?
One war falls upon every generation. My grandfather drove out the Ambersons back when he was 27. My father destroyed that psychopath gangster, Maurice Bell, when he was a sprightly 30. At 69, I'd begun to think my war had passed me over. But my time has come at last. Tomorrow, Vicus Varga declares war, and I'm obliged to answer.
So we're talking about Varga now.
I don't know how he thinks. I don't even know whether he plans his actions or not. I can't divine his purpose. Hell, I don't even know where he comes from. He's a man not of our breed, wouldn't you say? But when he arrived here, I invited him in, told him we could work together. An official invitation penned in my own hand and written on some very expensive paper. And can you imagine his reply? A fruit basket. What sense can be made of such a message?
I guess it means whatever you want it to.
Precisely.
I'm late for work, Mr. Sand.
You know, Jack, I could just give you $500,000 right now. Cash, whatever denominations you like. But I would never insult you so. If I went stalking my prey for so many years, I wouldn't want someone else to shoot it for me. I understand you, Jack. And I'll never ask you for anything that's contrary to your nature. Just think about our conversation. Think about it. And call me.
Like I said, it's a whole new life, and I've had to give up some old habits. One of them, keeping away from things that don't concern me. Now I can't afford the luxury. This spotlight I'm under, concerns is all I got. Tell him it's Boyd.
Püha järves elab kala, Eesti rahva maius pala kaske. Paranähtus tõuseb vara, võtab kaasa vallas vara raske. Auto tal on nagu sära, taljõn kui härja kara kaske. See ei hala järve äärde jõuda jala laske.
Progress. I was trying to raise 10-1, Sergeant Fossbach. Martensi in progress.
Looks like we have a situation here. 410A in progress. Progress.
Ashcon Race Team 1, Sergeant Hoffbach.
1113 in progress.
12:10 complete.
411 in progress.
trying to raise Team 1, Sergeant Softbox.
A in progress. Woo! 9-10B in progress.
11-11B.
Thank you.
progress.
Progress. Thank you.